So you're searching for your next classic pocket knife, except you've only got about 10 bucks. Well, that's a problem, huh? Most people would probably think you're just plain high, but maybe you need to clarify exactly what you mean by the word classic. Just like Plan 9 from Outer Space is a classic movie, the Cima M2 is also a classic knife, or more specifically, a classic gas station counter knife, or petrol station if you don't speak American. You know, the kind of knife usually found in a plastic jug or under a glass counter by the rolling papers and herbal supplements. Is that what we're calling them now? Also, did you drink every time I said the word classic? Maybe you should rewind it and start over. The M2 is an awesome knife if the measure of an awesome knife is being able to open your beer, open cracker wrappers, look tactical, right? It has a murdered out frame made out of steel with precious weight-saving holes. Badass weight-saving milling. The hollow ground blade is made from 5CRMOV steel, whatever that is, which is a high-end steel for a place that sells gourmet sandwiches and premium beer. The blade has a claimed HRC of 57, which is way better than an HRC of 55, 20, or 5. The knife is solidly built, although my sample did have some blade play and wasn't perfectly centered. So you should buy this knife if those are two things you look for in a blade. It has a slip joint mechanism, so it really doesn't lock, but stays in place very well with a firm click. If gas station knives tend for the blades to either open too easily or aren't easy to open, this falls in the it ain't easy side. This makes the M2 a two-handed opener for sure. It has a two-stage opening and closing, So when you're closing it, a firm press closes it about halfway and then another bump to close it the rest of the way. It does have the fingernail indent to assist in opening, but since I don't have mutant coke nails, I don't know, maybe I should try some bath salts. I felt it was easier for me to open the blade with a finger and a thumb on either side of the blade. Again, it's a two-handed opener. It's got a clip that allows for no flexibility in mounting. You've probably known a few people like that in your life, right? Am I right? I'll just leave it at that. But since it's a two-handed opener, who cares which way you carry it, right? Here are the basic dimensions. I'm going to go over the weight too, and I'll just talk a little bit while this stuff flashes on screen. Okay, so it has the bottle opener on one end, or if you don't drink, it's a keychain loop. Although in my opinion, it's too heavy for keychain carry, but that's just my opinion because people carry ridiculous amounts of crap on them because no one asked my opinion about it. So this knife is designed for places that have shitty knife laws because it's a, you know, well, kind of a, anyway, it doesn't lock even though it clicks firmly into place, like I said earlier. It's also sort of small, so it can probably avoid blade length restrictions too. Okay, let's see what else. It cuts stuff. You know that because, you know, that's a knife's job, right? And it opens bottles okay. So if you want an okay knife that does things okay, then okay. It has a cool talon shape too, so there's that. If you like this review, please browse my channel for more stuff just like it. It's an outdoor gear review channel, so there's knives, tools, flashlights, and headlamps. Who knows what else, or what the future holds except for a robot apocalypse. Oh, and some cool knife and flashlight reviews. Please subscribe and comment below my videos because it enables me to do reviews and entertain you a little bit of the time. Thanks for watching. Seriously, you're awesome.